My name is Sara Wykes, and I'm a writer here at Stanford Hospital and Clinics. I was born in 1950. I started smoking when I was about 19, and it wasn't until, oh gosh, I was almost out of high school when the first Surgeon General's report was issued saying, oh, by the way, smoking cigarettes is directly linked to a whole long list of things that are bad for your health. My grandfather lived to be 98, smoked cigars all his life. My dad started smoking when he was also a teenager, even though I already knew that it was not a good thing. I smoked for 30 years, about a pack a day. I kept smoking, even though I knew that it was bad for me, and my poor mother would beg and plead, and actually my father was diagnosed with emphysema, and then he was diagnosed with lung cancer. And that reminded me that there were things going on in my body that I couldn't sense. And I would probably take a step toward finding out what was going on with my lungs. As a writer, in preparation for the work I was doing around Lung Cancer Awareness Month, I spoke to Stanford's thoracic oncologists and to their radiologists about lung cancer screening. What I started to hear from them was the results of this study showed that for a certain group of people with certain risk factors, that a low-dose CT scan was very effective at finding cancers at a very early stage. And in fact, the results of this large study showed a 20% reduction in mortality. So I decided, hearing all of this from these physicians, that, oh, well, that's right. I smoked X number of cigarettes for X number of years, and I quit X number of years ago, and I have this family history. No, look at that, I'm qualified.
This is Sara Wykes.
Right. The National Comprehensive Cancer Network has established a series of criteria for people who they recommend should have the screening. So later this week, I will go over to one of Stanford's imaging centers, and I'm actually at this point really looking forward to knowing, after years and years of wondering, you know, what is going on in my lungs. And I've accepted the various realities that could emerge depending on what those images show.